Hey everyone, Morgan here. So today I wanted to talk about being physically fit. And really what I mean by being physically fit is being physically healthy. And I think that being physically healthy has a lot to do with being mentally healthy as well. Our bodies and our minds are our greatest assets when it comes to preparedness. And I think a lot of us take that for granted because, most of us are not living in a crisis every single day. And when it comes to an emergency or disaster, we can hypothesize and think about it. But generally, when preppers think about these kinds of things, they're thinking about the gear. What is all this gear that's going to get me through this? What gear is going to help me through this emergency or disaster situation, right? And let me be perfectly clear about what I mean by being physically fit. I don't mean that you have to go running 10 miles every single day, and I don't mean that you have to be some bodybuilder. I think that being physically fit simply means that, you can walk up a flight of stairs without getting completely winded. However, I did read somewhere once that every human ever in life has a difficulty with stairs, no matter how physically fit they are, because stairs are just extremely stressful on the body. But in saying that, we should be able to walk up some stairs, maybe breathe a little hard at the end, but not feel like dying, right? Even just getting out and walking a few times a week is better than doing absolutely nothing. In fact, when I was going out and walking several times a week, it was anywhere from 3 to 5 times a week. I went out with Kid Rogue, and we'd go out walking and for several months, and then all of a sudden I needed to run a 5K. Well, I hadn't trained for a 5K outside of the fact of just walking. One day I decided to jog. I jogged an entire 5K in a very good amount of time. It was because I was physically fit. Not that I was super skinny, but because I was out and active regularly. That's the key thing here. We want to be out and active on a regular basis. And walking is really all you need to do. I've talked about this in past videos, but I think that that's one of the most important things that I really want to drive home here today in this video. That even if you could just get out and walk around your neighborhood, a mile, half a mile, a few times a week, it's going to be better than just sitting on the couch and doing absolutely nothing. And there are little things that you can do every day as well, such as parking further away from the doors, whenever you're going to go into any stores. Take the stairs instead of taking the elevator, and just these little things that can really make a big difference overall. And while you may not see immediate results, you're going to see them when it really counts. And truly, age is just a number. I have seen articles on people in their 80s who are physically fit because they get out there and make the change that they need to see, as in they get out and walk. And walking doesn't just help, your physical being. It helps everything. It helps your joints. It helps, it gets that blood flowing, your heart rate up. It helps everything. It helps, it even helps clear your mind. It is just so good for everything. My mother is in her 60s and she's physically fit. She walks 5 miles a day, no problem, every day. She also does a treadmill at home and she just eats right and she's physically fit. Whether bugging in or bugging out, the stress of an emergency or disaster takes a toll on your body and your mind. And whether, like I said, whether you're bugging in or bugging out, the stress that the emergency or disaster will have could be detrimental to your physical body and mind. All the gear in the world won't help you if you're not fit enough to handle any situation that comes your way to be physically able to handle those situations. And I'm not just talking about throwing your backpack on your bag and walking out through the woods, because the reality is that's not a situation that most of us will probably be doing right off the bat. However, there could be a time where you do need to do that. And so I do still suggest that people throw on their bug out bag and walk around the block, maybe go for a hike with it, that kind of thing. But outside of just that, you know, even if I never trained with my bug out bag, simply getting out and being physically active by walking, hiking every once in a while, whatever physical activity that you enjoy doing, rollerblading, skateboarding, biking, whatever activity you enjoy doing it on a semi-regular basis. And it doesn't have to be for very long. 30 minutes is plenty. Endorphins don't last forever. And while they may present themselves in the beginning, they just won't last. So an emergency or disaster happens, you get all revved up. Oh yeah, endorphins rolling, right? Yeah, well, you may have superhuman strength for a very short amount of time, but that's not gonna last. And after that superhuman strength goes away, you're going to be exhausted. So you're gonna have to be physically fit to be able to handle whatever comes your way after the initial onslaught of whatever crisis may happen. Bugging in can be very stressful too. It can be as physically demanding as, you know, bugging out, if not more. You know, when you think about what you do on a daily basis just around your house, think about that in a crisis situation. Maybe you're having to board your windows. Maybe, you know, you're having to go collect water from some source. You have to think of the terrains. You have to think, is it raining, snowing? What's going to make it harder for you to do a certain activity in a crisis than it is in your just everyday life? Now, while saying all this, I do understand that medical conditions can be a deterrent for being physically fit, and I totally understand that. You know yourself and your limitations and exactly what you can and cannot do, but please try to get out there as much as you possibly can. You know, I've heard of many situations where just getting out there and getting active has actually helped people in certain medical conditions. I know someone who just had a kidney transplant, and it was very shortly after that she was eager to get out and about and walking, and she looked better, felt better, it just everything. So we're kind of a mind over matter sort of situation here. We want to be able to handle a crisis that comes our way. You don't need to be super skinny. And also, people who are overweight aren't necessarily people who are not healthy. I've known people who are overweight, but they're healthy. They can go run 10Ks. In fact, I saw someone who was a little overweight, and he was booking it in this 10K that I was doing. In fact, he looked like he was doing better than me. So anyway, it's not how you look. It's how you feel. It's how you eat. It's how active you are. And just in general, you want to try to live and be as healthy as you absolutely can be. And look, none of us are perfect. We're all human. We all want the cake. We all want the spam. Okay, go ahead and eat it. Go ahead and take a break, you know, after you've gotten home from work. Have that beer. Do whatever you need to do. Have that fried chicken. But also, let's make sure that we're paying attention to our body and mind as well by trying to get out and be active as often as we possibly can be. Get up, get out, and get active as often as you possibly can. The better you can prepare your physical body for an emergency and disaster, the better everything else will follow. Also, if you have children, this is a prime time to get outside with your children and teach them the value of what being physically healthy really means. So before I sign out, I just want to be perfectly clear that I'm not trying to shame anyone, and I'm certainly not trying to preach a gospel of being super healthy and super fit. However, I think it's very important as preppers that we prepare every aspect, including our bodies and definitely our minds. So thank you all so much for watching. Conquer tomorrow by preparing today. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye.